Yo! Good evening, or morning, or whatever it might be, wherever you are. So, we're back in the studio. We have the pen. We have the phone. And I'm going to attempt to recreate probably one of the best pictures I've done. Definitely the best portrait I've done. So, stick with me. We'll roll a little intro. And then we'll get chatting and we'll get to the edit. Catch you in a minute. So, as you've seen, I'm gonna wait for the train. Let's see, 7:44 to Birmingham. I'll make the most of it and have a refreshment. So, it's a mess in here, I tell you. It's a mess in studio. Right, let's carry on. Where were we? So, if you follow my social media of any genre, you will see that I've done a bit of portrait. Now, there's two reasons why I've been getting into a bit of portrait. Reason number one is I can't go anywhere. Not because I'm isolating or any of that business. Thankfully, that's pretty much done and dusted now. Certainly, it's not done and dusted, but yes, still work, blah, 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 blah. Don't care about that. Can't go anywhere because the kids are off school. So I generally have the kids if the wife's working and vice versa. So it makes going out and doing my usual kind of vlog style a bit hard. And photography full stop is a bit hard because I can't go many decent places. I could take the kids, but that's even harder. So I turned to a bit of portrait, mostly self. Done a few quirky little edits and had a nice bit of fun. Got a new speedlight for a little gig a while back. Anyway, I done some. I needed a speedlight, so I done a few shots of that. And I've been practicing on myself. And then my parents came up, my mum and dad came up, which have not been to my house for a couple of years because of various COVID and restrictions and whatever, obviously. So I was like, brilliant. Got an old man. Right, sit down, I'm gonna get a shot of you. So we got a few shots of my dad. There was a couple of my mum as well. Now, with these shots, I then had the idea to merge the two together, creating this. Now, this, not broke the internet, far from, but I shared it on my usual pages, but I also shared it on one called Professional Photographers, I think. Now, I'm not technically professional, although the difference between amateur and professional is paid and hobbyist. I do make the odd quid, so that technically makes me a professional. But I don't put myself into the bracket of half of the professionals that are on there. Although what I did notice about the group and various other groups of similar style, they're so photoshopped and edited. Now, I know what you're about to see and what you've seen are heavily edited to my style, and everyone's style is completely up to themselves. And they're not that critical on there so far, which is nice. They're all very similar. Most of the people aren't wearing many clothes. And most are very, to the point of so soft in the sort of the textures that their face just looks flat and you just got kind of eyes and a mouth. It's a bit, whereas I prefer the texture. Obviously that works more with the men than the women, which is why I quite like photographing the older wrinkly generation, because I think they photograph better for a portrait. Their face tells a story, whereas I think a bird standing in a field and next to nothing, yes, I've done that, doesn't tell as much story necessarily as kind of that weathered face of someone who's worked. You know what I mean? And that was kind of a look that I was going for with my dad. You know, he's the father of five children. He was a London fireman. Had quite a serious injury when he was in the fire brigade, and then he became self-employed as a videographer, if that's the right term, cameraman. And he had a few other bits and pieces, other jobs. He was one of the best ones I remember as a kid. He was a bailiff, if you can call him that. Yeah, he was a bailiff for Granada Studios. So he used to have to, they used to rent out, Granada Studios obviously made TV programs, but they also rented TVs and whatever. I don't know if it was the same company. I'm assuming it wasn't the Granada Studios. So he was a bailiff for a while. He'd always come over with TVs and stuff in the back of the van. He'd be like, kids, got this. And it's like, okay, cool. But funny character, my old man. Yeah, he's all right. I'm sure there's many more stories he's got. I don't doubt he's dodgy as. Because how he afforded the house and five kids on a wage that he was on is beyond me. But don't go investigating him, anybody. I'm sure he's perfectly fine. He just works hard for it. So, we're going to change the setup slightly. We're going to flip me into a portrait. We'll pop the phone screen up on the side. And I'm going to try and recreate that shot very simply. I'm not going to do the two edits of my face and my dad's face, of which I've already put on the screen. I'm not going to show how I edited them because that's going to make the video ridiculously long. I'm just going to show, very simply, the apps I used to merge it, and then a few final touches in Lightroom, because once they're merged, you'll notice there's a difference in kind of texture and colour. So, well, they're both black and white, but you'll see what I mean. So let's set that up, and yes, in a minute, didn't put out a sign, did I? In a minute, I'll be sat one side or the other, and we'll get the phone screen on. Hold on. So, here we go. We have the fucking hell. Oh, dearie me. I'm going to leave it in. I'm just going to leave that in. You can make that up. Hang on. Right. No, I'm getting mentioned in comments and everything, but I can't turn off my mobile data, because then I won't be able to use the apps. So you might get the odd name flash up and comments and whatever, I don't know. I'm just going to promote them, you know what I mean? If your name's lucky enough to be in here, bonus. So, let me just quickly click these apps so I can get this started. I'm so unprepared, as always. So, here we go. Screen record in 3, 2, 1. We're recording, hopefully. Right, I use the app Polish. Could be Polish, but I'm pretty sure it's Polish. And it's a free Android app. There's a pro version that gives you various other filters and different bits and pieces you can do. And you can do a lot in this app. Now, I'm a bit of a sucker for not experimenting with new apps because I know how to use these. So for me, I have an image in mind. I can just go in, I can sort it out pretty quick. I should try more stuff. But anyway, so we're not gonna go into photo, that's a complete lie. We're gonna go to collage, okay? And we're going to go into portrait vlog because I have the pictures organized, and we are going to click 1 and 2 and next. Right, here are the two pictures, very straightforward. We are now, I need fingers for this one because this is a pinch and move kind of job. I'm going to obviously pull that one to the middle. Now my dad's one, I'm going to flip it because his right side of the face is, here comes one, there you go, see, there's a name, shout out. His face is lighter on his right, so I need that to become his left, so it saves me a bit of hassle. So I can flip that round, and we'll bring that in. Now this is the bit where it's tricky. You've got to line everything up perfect. Obviously my chin won't be perfect because I haven't got one. That's why I grow a beard, because without a beard I look like Bart Simpson. Now that, at a quick glance, it's not far off. Whoa! It's going to be a long one, guys. You might want to go and get a drink or something. I'll stop. What are you looking about? So we've both got a wonky nose, and we've both got a huge nose. So I think we're going to go. We're going to go there. Don't push anything. I don't know what's going on. Right. We're going to save that. Then we're going to send that into Lightroom. So the merging bit, dead easy. Yes, it helps if you use sort of same settings, same surroundings, you know, the same sort of style of picture. So ideally, if you're going to do this, you want the two people in the same room, standing in the same place, take a photo, because then it's going to make your life a lot easier, because if not, you've got different depths of fields, you can have different, if you use a different lens, it's not going to match up, and it doesn't work very well with kids, because their heads are smaller. So therefore, the mouth's kind of halfway up your face, or the top of their head doesn't line up with yours. So it does work better with someone, probably a relation, and someone who equally is fully grown. That is what I've noticed since trying to do it again with my own kids. It doesn't work as well. I can do it with my two children, and I have done, but I haven't done it with me and my boys because it just doesn't work. So we have shared that to Lightroom. So now let's go and find Lightroom. And now we'll get to editing it. And this bit doesn't actually take as long as you think. So, this might not be as perfect as the last one, because obviously I did go to town on the last one. I'm gonna have to sit forward, get myself comfy. So what we see straight away is the image looks like a face, but it looks like I've had a stroke. And I've got a line straight down the middle of my face. That's the first bit you wanna get rid of before you start kind of lightening up my dad. We'll call him my dad because he is. So we're going to go in and we're going to go into the healing tool. We're going to select the size, make sure we're all right. And we're going to, whoa, not that big. Put it on feather. So we'll put that feather 100%. And we're literally going to draw a line straight up there. And it's going to try and take it from somewhere, which is fine because that's what we want it to do. And then we're going to basically play about trying to get this line to face. You need to do a couple of different hills basically. So we'll now do a slightly smaller one there, let it take it from that side, we'll do a slightly smaller one there, and so on. And then we'll sort of go a bit smaller. Oh, not on that one, we need another one, yes. Hill, you get the gist. I'm not going to bother speeding it up, you can skip through on the, I'm not going to put timestamps in or any of that because I just don't know how to do it. So now, because the hair is dead straight, we want to kind of take that hair off slightly. There we go. And then we'll just put a bit of a wavy line in. So it's just not so clean cut. Because that's what we don't want. We don't want it so clean that it looks like it's blatantly two pictures. So straight away, the forehead is not bad. Just a dodgy haircut. In fact, I had some comments. I'll keep doing this while I'm chatting. I had a comment on one of the groups that I put it on saying, great photo, shit haircut. And I was like, you do realise this is two people. At which point he was then quite apologetic. And I said, you know, this is my dad and I, you know. And he was like, oh, yeah, didn't realise that. So no, he didn't, did he? Because he didn't actually read what I'd done. So I'm going to remove, oh, not that. I'm going to remove this big line here. See if that goes out my way in a minute. That's one of my wrinkles, that is. I'm trying to soften that up slightly. So yeah, as you see, the Lightroom app is awesome on mobile. So now we're going to go down to here. So many close-ups of my nose. This is incredible. Look at all the blackheads. No shame. Right, I'm going to, again, just get a slight sort of, where's he going to take that from? Just to give him my forehead. Apparently the forehead looks like my moustache. But equally, it doesn't massively matter because it'll probably do it good enough. Oh, look, I took my lip piercing off. My dad would call the lip piercing. I don't want that to for my eye. Now you're just being silly. Just make that to go along then. Make that one hair. Take that one from there. Again, we'll take. That from there. And we'll soften up the line of that beard there. So let's have a look how we're looking. How are we looking? We're starting to look alright. I'll get to the eye in a minute. That was another one I had as well, another comment. How did you do that with the eyes? And I was like, in what sense? The colour or the shape? And he said, the shape. How do you make the eye look droopy? Age 35 years, that's how you make it look droopy. Again, I was like, you do realise this is two shots. Like it says at the top here, this is a composite of my dad and I. You know, I appreciate the comments. But bloody hell, read what I've written. So I think because we've got this, I'll draw a line. Because we've got, oh, no, I won't draw a line, I'll do a selective, and you'll see a line. Where I've got, obviously, on the one side, you can see my t-shirt, and on the other side, my t-shirt's different. I'm going to put that in there. I'm going to drop the exposure down on that. I'm going to make it hard as well, so it's, it gives it more of a harsher line. Like I said, this won't be as perfect as the last one. Did take me probably about 45 minutes and I went backwards a couple of times and back to it forwards. So I'm just going to remove some of these big white hairs here. It's a bit distracting, nothing too crazy, but take your eye off it slightly. Now I'm going to remove that bit of wrinkle just there. That's my dad's one, that is. That's not one of mine. So we're there. So now we're just going to do the selective. We're going to selective over the, oh, he says. I'm going to drop a big radial over this side. Make sure the feather's up about 90% we'll start with. And we just want to try and colour match now. Because obviously that side was slightly light, my side was slightly lighter. So again, this is now just a bit of trial and error. And it is just all about sliding the sliders. Another train, can't look, I'm too busy. I reckon I can even drop the clarity down slightly on that one. Let's have a look, see how we're looking. Just got to keep going back, having a look, going in and out, seeing where all the imperfections are, which, like I say, if you want to do this, see that lip there, that's not good, does it look? See, there's a line right there. So we'll swap that over to that side. Yeah, it's just about going back through and removing any imperfections and really starting to tweak that. So we have different color eyes. The next one will be a radial. Pop it just on the bit that we want. Make it so it's solid. And then we need to go into color. And again, we now need to drop out slightly so I can see my other eye. We now need to color match. Wrong slider, hang on, that one. We now need to color match that eye as best we can. Like I said, we can fine tune it another day. This is just to show people basically how easy it is. Go down a bit, I reckon. Something like that. Let's have a look. They're not bad. Yeah, I'm looking at it thinking, well, what's next? But actually, that's not for a quick one, you know what I mean? I don't know how long it has been, probably a bit longer than I realised, but for what, a 15 minute edit, if that? Yeah, obviously, like I say, I've done the two original edits first. So basically those two edits were pretty much just up the clarity, up the texture, obviously made it black and white, remove imperfections, make the eyes slightly whiter, stuff like that. That's pretty general stuff, and I've got various vlogs in there about editing portrait and stuff. It's not to everyone's taste and it's not natural. And that's what gets the purists slightly upset, because they're like, oh, it doesn't look natural, the eyes wouldn't naturally be that colour. I know. I had another comment, and I shared this on one of my own pages, which if you are watching and you're not on it, A View to Meet Photography and Film on YouTube, Facebook, go check it out. We encourage people, basically, it's only a small group, basically mainly around England, but obviously get other people involved, bring people to the group that are from your area, and you can arrange some meets, and you might meet new photographers, etc. That sounded like I was so plugging that, like a sponsor. It wasn't, but I put a comment on there, so some of you may have seen this, saying, how did you get, what was it? Are your eyes really that blue, or has this been edited? And I'm just like, well, I'm not black and white. The mind boggles for some people. It really does boggle. But I believe I'm pretty happy with how that's come out, just as a quick one-off. In my one, I must have put my face slightly more to the left because I still have my lip piercing in, whereas in this one, I haven't. So, yeah, there you go. That is what we've got. While the screen's on, I will quickly show you another one, actually. It's just for a quick bit of fun. I had a very, very quick tinker. Look at all these selfies, eh? Blimey, full of. I had a very, very quick little tinker with one. He says, well, I deleted it. Maybe it's down here. Yes, this one here, this is my beard with my dad's face. So that's what I'm going to look like when I'm 75. Right, we are going to end that bit of video. 11 minutes, winner. And I might as well just stay portrait for now. So there you go. That is how I done that shot. Incredibly easy, no Photoshop, no mucking about, no creating layers and dragging this and dragging that on a phone. I know I bang on because it's all I've got. It's all I can use. I have a laptop sat right here. I turn it on, I lose the plot slightly, and I close it before I smash it. I can't figure it out for toffee. Tried to get my microphone working the other night, that didn't work, so that went across the garden. I can't handle it. So I'm looking forward to getting out and getting some vlogs going. So stick around with the channel. If you like what you see, chuck it a thumbs up if you like it. Give it a like and subscribe and all the usual stuff. And I will be doing some more edits. In fact, on that note, YouTube Shorts, what a waste of time. Absolute waste of time. It basically, unless you say, I killed my cat using a smoke grenade, no one bloody clicks it. It's utter rubbish. I don't get the algorithm or any of that. I've got a few on there, very short, little 1 minute edits. Maybe people just don't like them. But it doesn't even get watched. They don't even look at it. So that's the algorithm, that's not me. But anyway, whatever. That's how you do it. Hope you enjoyed it. I'm not gonna rabble it on. I'm gonna go in and probably edit some more pictures. Thanks for watching. See you later.